Welcome back for the next class, and during this class we will again study about the gravitation, and we will apply the gravitational law to calculate the value of g. In previous class we have calculated the value of gravitational mass of the earth on the basis of by using Newton's law of gravitation. So here it is gravitation. This is our fourth lecture for the gravitation, and during this lecture we will see the value of g is decreasing by going to the higher altitude. Suppose an object of mass m is placed at a height h from the surface of the earth. If the mass of the earth is ma and the radius of earth is re, so the distance between the mass m and the center of the earth is re plus h, and then the Newton's law of gravitation. Then you will apply the Newton's law of gravitation by using this concept, how it is varying and how it changes whenever you move above the surface of the earth. If you look at, suppose this one is earth, here the distance radius of the earth, it is equal to re this one is re, and when you move above the surface of the earth, equal to height h, and if you calculate the distance of the body from center of the earth up to this point, it will be equal to plus h plus re. And this one is re. So it means if this is a body of mass m which you have lifted, you have moved above the surface of the earth, if you calculate the distance, this one is basically body of mass m. And if you look at the distance between the two bodies center to center, that it is equal to, if this earth, you have moved the object up to a height h, and then the object mass is m. The distance between the two is re plus h. So this is the distance between the two. The bodies are having mass, that is me. This is basically mass of us. And the upper, you have lifted the object, the mass of that object is small m. The distance between the two is re plus h. So you are taking the square of the distance between their centers. So fg is equal to g MEM divided by RE plus H square. So to calculate the value of small g, you are using this formula, that is g is equal to GME divided by RE square at the surface of the earth. But when you move it up to a certain height, that is RE plus H. So here it is the variation of the g with altitude. You have moved any object from the surface of the earth and the mass of the earth is m. You have moved this object, the object mass is small m. The distance between the two bodies center to center is basically equal to re plus h. This is the radius of earth, this one is the height above the surface of the earth, and the total distance between the two bodies will be re plus h. And this is the force acting between the two bodies is gravitational force. It is equal to mg, and this is the force calculated by using Newton's law of gravitation. And if you put the value, m is cancelled with the other m, you are getting value of g at a height h. So this is the formula to calculate the value of g at height h. So when you put the values, this is the technique to use this force acting, gravitational force acting is equal to the weight of the object, and formula to calculate weight of the object is mg, and it is equal to me divided by re plus h square. And then just this gh, value of g at height h, is this one. So you calculate at the surface, the value of g at the surface will be equal to radius of r. So the value of g is calculated by using this formula. If you lift any object up to the surface of the earth and then you move up to a certain height h, then the distance between the two bodies will become
radius of Earth added with the height up to which you have moved any object from the surface of the Earth. So here another topic to understand that is artificial satellite. These are the objects revolving around the planets in stable orbits. Moon is a natural satellite of the Earth. Scientists send artificial satellite which carries the instruments or passengers in space revolving around the Earth. During the circular motion, satellite gets the required centripetal force from the Earth's gravitational field. They are basically falling under the influence of Earth's gravitational fields, and this force keeps the objects in a centripetal force to circulate. These are the satellite, natural satellite. These are the artificial types of the satellites, and the man-made satellites which are released, which are moved in the space for different purposes to find out the location and number of other applications on the surface of the Earth communication system. And there are different types of tasks and given to find out even the structure of the Earth. The internal structure of the Earth is also calculated by using the satellite images and other types of applications, which are very much complex nowadays. Now, this is one another figure where you see that this is a satellite, and satellite is revolving around the Earth. So the distance, these are some points to remember. The distance of the Earth in kilometer is this one. Speed of the Earth to which it is moving, that is 11,300 kilometers per hour, that is 7,000 miles per hour. And if you look at the orbit around the Earth, orbit of the moon, that is, it is at a distance r. So this is the height h from the surface of the Earth. So the radius of that satellite is calculated by using the radius of the Earth plus height above the surface of the Earth. So this is another example where the satellites are moving. This is the gravitational force formula used to calculate the gravitational force up to a certain height h when you are moving any object, and this object force is calculated by using Newton's law of gravitation, and then by using this law you are able to calculate the velocity required to move the object up to a certain height. So this is the formula to calculate centripetal force. It is Fc is equal to mv square divided by r, and this is the formula to calculate gravitational force, gmem divided by r square, and this is the formula to calculate gravitational force which is responsible to produce centripetal force. Centripetal force is provided by gravitational force induced by this force to revolve around the Earth in a circular motion. So if you compare these two, what happened? This centripetal force is responsible to produce gravitational force, and you compare the gravitational force and you get the velocity, and this velocity is the required velocity to revolve the object inside a circular path of radius r. So if you look at the backside, which force is responsible to keep the object in a circular motion? That is basically centripetal force. And this centripetal force is from where this force comes? This force comes after gravitational force. When a gravitational force acts on any body of mass m above the surface of the Earth, basically this force creates another type of a force, that is centripetal force. And when you compare these two forces together, you are basically calculating amount of velocity which is required to move the object in its orbit. And this value of this velocity is basically, if you put all values, gme constant, m, this me is also constant mass of Earth, and this is the distance from the center of the Earth. If you put all values, you get 3,753 miles per second. This is the value of the speed which a satellite requires to move in a certain orbit. So what will be the velocity minima required? This will be the value of minimum requirement to move any type of a satellite in its orbit. That is 7.9 minimum requirement of the velocity to keep the satellite in its orbit, to move in its orbit. So these are some of the interesting. These are some of the assignments, give questions to solve at the end of your class. What is artificial satellite? What is the speed of artificial satellite in space? what happens when a body goes away from the surface of the earth, is value of E dependent upon altitude, make a chart of the solar system, solve the examples given in the book. These are some of the questions given for this chapter to make it clear how much you have learned and where you have applied. So if you move back from the same topic, what you have done, basically you have calculated the value of G with altitude. First we have done the value of G at the surface. There was only R, E, radius of the earth. When you have moved any object up to a certain height H, you have added the distance, radius of earth with the height, and then you have calculated the value of small g, and it is clear from the formula that the value of g will decrease. And then you have calculated about studied about artificial satellite, what types of the satellites are artificial satellites, what are the examples of artificial satellite, and then we have studied about velocity, that is how much velocity is required to keep the satellite in a certain orbit. Basically there are some concepts, theories or researches which are used to release the object from the surface of the earth with a certain velocity. That is the minimum requirement to overcome the gravitational force. With this our class ends. I hope you people have understood the main concept of the topic. Thank you very much for your patience.